And I would walk 500 miles. And I would walk 500 more. Just to be the man who figured out what the hell havering means. Okay, folks, so welcome to Movie Review Tuesday. I came across this little gem the other day. I don't know. That's not the one I want. I don't know how I somehow missed this. But I found it the other day. Oh, by the way, today's episode is brought to you by Netflix. Netflix, 30 billion viewers and 12 paid subscriptions, can't be wrong. So this is what I found here was Cowboys and Aliens, which, I mean, right off you think, okay, this is something dumb, right? And it's kind of what you expect, maybe a little higher quality with the effects and stuff, but what really got me about it is, now watch when I start this preview, it'll look like pretty much what you're expecting out of a movie like this. Let's see, I think we can make that a little bigger, huh? When I saw the preview, I thought, is that Harrison Ford? And it is. Cowboys and Aliens. Sounds pretty much like a, sci-fi channel special. This is no volume control on there. Anyway, just look at this. Like I said, just seems like it'd be a sci-fi channel special. But look, you got Harrison Ford, Daniel Craig. Oh, it was directed by Jon Favreau, Harrison Ford, Olivia Wilde, Sam Rockwell, Paul Dano, Keith Carradine, Clancy Brown, and Daniel Craig. I mean, I'm telling you, if you haven't seen it, it's a hidden gem. Anyway, I just had to share that with you. You know, one of these days I'll learn to just like edit this stuff. And actually, I think if I'd tried, I could have figured out how to actually get that clip and add it. You know, the one day I did try and finally figure out how to take, the one day my camera cut off, and I was like 17 minutes into a 20 minute video, and I just decided to pick it up where I left off, and I did manage to stitch the two together. So that's a start, you know. But I'd really like to, I just got to play around with that stuff more. So there's things I could do to make some more interesting videos. Anyway, Cowboys and Aliens is the name of that movie. And like I said, it's like a B movie with an A cast. And I'm sure all those people knew what they were getting into. I can't imagine they all did it just for the money. I don't know. But the basic plot is Daniel Craig wakes up out in the desert and doesn't remember a thing. And he's got this strange bracelet on his arm. And it takes place, I think it was around like 1890. Because it was post-Civil War. Harrison Ford was a Civil War colonel. And now he's a big-time rancher, you know, and it's the typical thing with the rich guy who, like, runs the whole territory. Everybody does whatever he says. But anyway, so Daniel Craig Wakes up, doesn't remember who he is. He has this thing on his arm. And later on, when the aliens attack, the thing comes to life and he can, it's one of their, obviously one of their weapons. But the aliens are kidnapping people, and we get the good guys, the bad guys, and the Indians all have to join forces to go try to save their people. And I won't ruin the end for you, because, you know, like you can't guess what'll happen in the end. But anyway, I'm just saying, it seems like a dumb little movie, but I had fun. I mean, you go into a movie like this not expecting much, and I was kind of pleasantly surprised. And it's, you know, like I said, it was a little higher quality than you would normally expect for a movie of this type. You know, it had good special effects, had good writing, I guess. You know, I hesitate to say that just because, as far as I'm concerned, the plot was pretty predictable. But I don't know, maybe you can't always go by me with that, because, you know, I've been watching movies for like 75 years now, and it gets to be where I'm sure a lot of you are the same. You see the opening scene and you pretty much know where the whole movie's going. You know, you'll sit there and you'll see who's in it, and it's like, okay, he's going to be the good guy, he's going to be the bad guy, who's pretending to be a good guy. And this detective is going to fall in love with that lady, and, you know, all that. And you always know it's going to come down to, you know, the fight scene at the end between the two head guys that somehow have been marksmen through a two-hour movie. And then when they face each other, the bullets are just flying all over the place. Or any. But on the other hand, let's give a shout out to The Sixth Sense. One of the few movies that I got to the end of and went, oh my God, is that what was going on? I'll throw this out there too, on a similar vein, but with books. If any of you like reading like suspense novels, mysteries, a guy I was reading quite a bit for a while, Harlan Coben. He would write those kind of novels, and, you know, once again, with books, a lot of times you know where they're going, but he was one that I'd get to the last chapter and be like, wait a minute, the butler did it? You know, whatever. And he didn't use tricks. I can remember I went through a lot of mysteries at one time in my life, you know, the Agatha Christie's and all those. And I always hated, because what I would do is I read, as I would read them, you know, just like when you watch one of those movies, you're trying to decide who the killer was or whatever. So the whole time you're reading it and you're putting the clues together. And I always hated some of those when they'd get to the end and it'd be, oh, but what you didn't realize is his brother-in-law was hiding in the attic all along, and he did it, you know? I always felt that was just sort of a cheap way to not, you know, figure out a good way to do the story. But anyway, Cowboys and Aliens is what I was talking about. If you have Netflix, check it out. If you don't have Netflix, ask around, and I'm sure somebody will say, oh yeah, well, I have my brother-in-law's account information. You can just join in there. I don't know how Netflix does it. Oh, I guess they've started cracking down on that, but I guess there's some people they haven't caught up with, allegedly. Anyway, folks, if you see this before noon on Tuesday, one more reminder of the live stream with Finkel about the our West Wing discussion, which hopefully if we get a few people, we're going to make that like a weekly thing for a while. But anyway, check that out. Hopefully that'll be interesting to more than just us. And peace out.